Hey, my loves, got my cacao. This is part two to kids who feel disconnected. So I literally did a live about 20 minutes ago about kids who feel disconnected from their parents, and my private messages have just blown up. So, and it's from people like around my, I'm 53, it's around my age going, my mum does this to me, my dad does this to me, it triggers the shit out of me. Okay, this is how you're gonna fix it. You ready? I can't stop my mum correcting me, but I can go into the wisdom of it. This is the thing. You gotta understand that everything around us is a diagnostic tool to what is going on within us. So a trigger is actually here for us to use as a diagnostic tool. So if my mum's triggering me, and so I'll give you an example. We went to the movies, Beetlejuice, on Saturday, and I said something, I can't remember what it was, and she tried to fix it, and I felt this little thing, and I went, ah, this is this thing. So what I do is I go in the wisdom of it. First thing I do is this: do I do this to anybody else? One. Two, do I do this to myself? Three, I know that when my mum is trying to over-explain or trying to fix it, she's actually in a shame response. She's in a shame spiral that she's got it wrong. And this is what happens. Shame is massive, right? Because shame triggers this. You can be a mum to a three-year-old kid and that kid throws a tantrum. You'll go into shame. Why am I not good enough for you to behave yourself in public right now? And as soon as you go into shame, you go into trauma response. There are four major trauma responses. Fight, which is over-explain, try and fix, it's a control thing. Flee, so you'll run away. The third one is freeze, you'll shut down. The fourth one is people please. There's a fifth one which is sick, but it's not that common. So when my mum does it to me, I now know that my job is to go into one, understanding it's not about me, it's about her, and two, calm her nervous system down. So this is when I'll say to her, my mum's 81, and I'll say things like, you know, you are the best nana in the world. Or I'll just give her a hug. It'll just be out of the blue. And it's instant. She'll go, aw, thank you, darling. And it's done. She'll stop telling me what to do. Because really what she's trying to do is she's trying to cover her own shame. Like, didn't I not educate Emma better, you know, enough? Did I not do what this, why she got problems? Emma shouldn't have problems. That's really what my mum is going through at the time. So she'll go into her natural trauma state, which is fight, which is control. Control is the over-explain and trying to fix. I'm the same. I'm exactly the same. But I go, I hold my lips. In my head, I'm saying all the things, right? It's like, I haven't nailed it. Like, it's a practice, okay? It's definitely a practice. But if you are, again, the daughter or the son of the person who does it to you, who tells you what to do all the time, just go into deep understanding that it's not actually about you. It's about them protecting themselves from shame or thinking they got it wrong. So this is your beautiful opportunity just to go, hey, I just want to interrupt you for a minute. Mom is like, have I told you you're looking really lovely today? And they'll be, what? It's called a break state. You literally break their state and you calm them down. Don't sit there and go, now, mummy, you need to breathe. Take deep breath. Don't do that. It's condescending. Just be really kind about it, because not everything is about you. That's a big one, isn't it? That was a big lesson for me. Not everything is about me. What I get triggered by is about me. What other people's actions is not about me. It's about their past that is filtering through their behaviors now. Fucking huge, isn't it? It's huge. Anyway, hope you enjoyed part two. Mwah. Love ya. Hey, my loves, got my cacao. This is part two to kids who feel disconnected. So I literally did a live about 20 minutes ago about kids who feel disconnected from their parents, and my private messages have just blown up. So, and it's from people like around my, I'm 53, it's around my age going, my mum does this to me, my dad does this to me, it triggers the shit out of me. Okay, this is how you're gonna fix it. You ready? I can't stop my mum correcting me, but I can go into the wisdom of it. This is the thing. You got to understand that everything around us is a diagnostic tool to what is going on within us. So a trigger is actually here for us to use as a diagnostic tool. So if my mum's triggering me, and so I'll give you an example. We went to the movies, Beetlejuice on Saturday, and I said something, I can't remember what it was, and she tried to fix it, and I felt this little thing, and I went, this is this thing. So what I do is I go in the wisdom of it. First thing I do is this. Do I do this to anybody else? 1. 2, do I do this to myself? 3, I know that when my mum is trying to over-explain or trying to fix it, she's actually in a shame response. She's in a shame spiral that she's got it wrong. And this is what happens. Shame is massive, right? Because shame triggers this. You can be a mum to a 3-year-old kid and that kid throws a tantrum, you'll go into shame. Why am I not good enough for you to behave yourself in public right now? And as soon as you go into shame, you go into trauma response. There are 4 major trauma responses. Fight, which is over-explain, try and fix, it's a control thing. Flee, so you'll run away. The 3rd one is freeze, you'll shut down. The 4th one is people please. There's a 5th one which is sick, but it's not that common. So when my mum does it to me, I now know that my job is to go into 1, understanding it's not about me, it's about her, and 2, calm her nervous system down. So this is when I'll say to her, my mum's 81, and I'll say things like, you know, you are the best nana in the world. Or I'll just give her a hug. It'll just be out of the blue. And it's instant. She'll go, aw, thank you, darling. And it's done. She'll stop telling me what to do. Because really what she's trying to do is she's trying to cover her own shame. Like, didn't I not educate Emma better, you know, enough? Did I not do what this, why she got problems? Emma shouldn't have problems. That's really what my mum is going through at the time. So she'll go into her natural trauma state, which is fight, which is control. Control is the over-explain and trying to fix. I'm the same. I'm exactly the same. But I hold my lips. In my head, I'm saying all the things. Right? It's like, I haven't nailed it. Like, it's a practice. Okay? It's definitely a practice. But if you are, again, the daughter or the son of the person who does it to you, who tells you what to do all the time, just go into deep understanding that it's not actually about you. It's about them protecting themselves from shame or thinking they got it wrong. So this is your beautiful opportunity just to go, hey, I just want to interrupt you for a minute. Mom was like, if I told you you're looking really lovely today. And they'll be, what? It's called a break state. You literally break their state and you calm them down. Don't sit there and go, now, mummy, you need to breathe, take deep breath. Don't do that. It's condescending. Just be really kind about it because not everything is about you. That's a big one, isn't it? That was a big lesson for me. Not everything is about me. What I get triggered by is about me. What other people's actions is not about me. It's about their past that is filtering through their behaviors now. Fucking huge, isn't it? It's huge. Anyway, hope you enjoyed part 2. Mwah. Love ya.